Kindergarten, if you were here before, the program is over for you. This is for first grade now. First grade. Okay?
We're going to get started in a couple of minutes.
Good to see everybody.
Hi, we're here.
It's okay. If you're brand new and you just came in, we're happy to have you. Welcome to our SEL Prep Rally.
My name is Tom.
Thank you, Mr. Walden. Okay, so I am Ms. Blaze, and my partner in crime for today is...
Hi, I'm Ms. Valencia. Welcome to SEL Day.
Thank you for being here, scholars. Let's go over some WebEx rules, guys. When we have presenters or anybody speaking, you guys have to be on mute so everybody can hear. Because if you're talking and somebody else is talking, we won't be able to hear what they're saying. So you have your smiley face at the bottom of the screen if you want to click on a reaction and show us something, that's perfectly fine. So when Miss Muniz or Miss Valencia or myself or Mr. Walden asks you something and we ask you to comment, then that's fine. But unless we ask you to say something, we shouldn't hear any little voices because we want to make sure everybody can hear us. Do we understand? Can I get a thumbs up if we understand? Thank you. Good morning, teachers, and welcome to you, Miss Reverendo. We see you. Thank you for being here with us. Today, we're here to celebrate SEL. If you can see our shirts, Miss Valencia and I have our shirt. It says SEL Day. Happy SEL Day. We are here to celebrate social emotional learning. Yay! Woo! We are going to have a really special, fun program for you today. So, Ms. Valencia?
Yes. So, thank you for coming. So, we're going to go over what social and emotional learning is, okay? So, what is social and emotional learning? Well, basically, social and emotional learning is the skills that teaches us how to identify our feelings, right? How to manage our feelings, how to make friends, how to solve problems, and how to make good decisions. So basically, every morning, you guys learn about this during your strong sessions. So every morning in your class, your teachers go over how you're feeling, what are some things that we could do to help us feel better when we're having a rough day. So I know we do some breathing, maybe some yoga. So those are all social emotional learning skills, boys and girls. So Social and emotional learning is just as important as learning how to read. It's just as important as learning how to write, how to do math, science, social studies, music. It's just as important because those skills are going to help us be strong scholars. Okay. Those skills are going to help us deal with when we have fights with our friends, when we're feeling upset, because sometimes we get really upset or angry and we don't know how to react. Right. So we have to learn how to manage those strong emotions. So social and emotional learning helps us be strong scholars, helps us be successful and friendly and kind to others. So that's why it's very important to learn those skills, because nobody likes anyone that's not nice, right? Nobody likes people that are yelling at you or mean to you. So we have to learn how to deal with those strong emotions. So we have a special guest today. She's going to come on really, really shortly. But before we do that, we want to sing a song with you. Okay, so Miss Blaze is going to share the lyrics of the song. I'm pretty sure if you heard this song before, but we added a little twist.
Okay, so this is the song. It's the same song that you've probably sang a thousand times. And this is the song. Miss Blaze cannot sing, but I will try my best. If you're happy and you know it, say SEL. If you're happy and you know it, say SEL. If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it, say SEL. Okay, so we're going to say 1, 2, 3. And we want you to sing, guys. Okay, ready? 1, 2, 3. If you're happy and you know it, say SEL. If you're happy and you know it, say SEL. If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it, say SEL.
So, before further ado, we would like to present our special presenter today. She is Miss Reverendo, and she is our reading coach. She helps teachers, she helps you, she helps us with reading and how to be better readers and learn all about reading and writing. So let's welcome Miss Reverendo. Yay, everyone.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning. Can everybody hear me?
Yes.
Yes.
Awesome. Boys and girls, good morning. I'm so happy to be here with you guys today. I'm going to share a really nice story with you today about being human. How many of you are human? Who's human? We're all human, right? And sometimes our days go really, really well, and sometimes they don't. But we're going to learn what it means to be human and then how we can change some of our bad days into better days. You guys ready? Awesome.
Yes.
I'm going to start sharing my screen so you can see my story. Okay. Can everybody see my screen?
Yes.
Good job. All righty. Let's listen. So our story is called I Am Human, A Book of Empathy. I was born a miracle, one of a billions, but unique. I am human. I am always learning. I'm finding my way and choosing my path on this incredible journey. I have big dreams. I see possibilities. I have endless curiosity. I make discoveries. I have a feeling of wonder. Oops. I am amazed by nature. I have a playful side. I find joy in friendships. I am human. But being human means I am not perfect and I make mistakes. I can hurt others with my words, my actions, and even my silence. I can be hurt too. I can be fearful of things I don't yet understand and timid to try something new. I have a heavy heart when I feel sadness. I am human. But then I remind myself that because I am human, I can make choices. I can move forward. A poor choice can become a better choice with thoughtfulness. A bad day can become a great day with kindness. I can act with compassion and lend a helping hand. I can treat others with equality and be fair. I can choose not to fight, but instead to listen and find common ground. I can say I'm sorry and ask for forgiveness. I am human, one of billions, but unique. I am not alone. I am connected to my friends, to my family, to the world. We are all humans together. And I will keep trying to be the best version of me. I am full of hope. I am human. And that is the end of our story. How many of you enjoyed that story? Very nice. I really like that story. Boys and girls, sometimes being human means that we make mistakes. And like I said, we have bad days, but we can always make it better. Who can tell me what were one of the ways that we can make a bad day a better day? How can we make a bad day a better day? Alexandra?
Being more kind and more respectful to others.
Absolutely. By being kind and respectful. Awesome. What else can we do, or what else happens? Sometimes we can say mean things to other people or do things that maybe are not the best things to do. What can we do when something like that happens, when we make a poor choice? What can we do, Leah?
Help others.
Well, we can definitely help others. What else can we do? If you do something that maybe you shouldn't have done and it wasn't a good choice, what's something that we can say? What can we say? Maybe we haven't made a good choice.
Who was that?
We can say,
Anyone? Can anyone help out our friend Leah? What can we say if we do something that maybe we shouldn't have done? Matthew? Can you help out Leah?
Help others?
We can help others, but what are the two words we can say when sometimes we say something or do something that maybe we shouldn't have? We could say, I'm what? Elias, can you help?
I'm sorry. And
I'm sorry. And what was that?
Ask for forgiveness.
Forgiveness. Excellent. You can ask for forgiveness and you can say, I'm sorry. So even though as humans, sometimes we make mistakes or sometimes our day doesn't go very well, there's always a way to turn that around and make it better. Okay. Thank you so much for letting me share that story with you. Does anybody have anything they want to share?
Thank you so much, Miss Reverendo. We really appreciate that great story. That was wonderful. Welcome.
Thank you. I really enjoyed it. Thank you for letting me stay with you guys.
Thank you. Can we give Miss Reverendo an air clap?
Yay! Yeah, Miss Reverendo! Woo! Scholars, our own Miss Valencia is going to talk to us about feelings.
I need everyone to take a deep breath. Breathe in through your nose, exhale through your mouth. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Breathe in. Breathe out. One more time. Breathe in. Two pictures. To help you learn about reading your emotions behind the mask, okay? So these two pictures go over how to help you read emotions. So when we go back to school on April 12th, boys and girls, some of us are going to be learning at school. Some of us are still going to be learning at home, but that's okay. The reason why we're doing it is because we all need to be safe. So one of the things that we all have to do when we go back to school is wear our mask, right? So it's kind of hard to tell what someone is feeling because a lot of our feelings are shown on our face, right? So it's kind of hard to tell what we're feeling when we're covering our mouth, right? So part of us, one of the things that we are going to have to learn is to be able to figure out how people are feeling by looking at their eyes, right? Because the eyes are the one thing that won't be covered. So there's some pictures of someone being joyful. So joy is another word for happiness. There's a picture for someone being angry, sad, someone showing empathy. And I know empathy is a big word, but I'm pretty sure you guys have heard of that word. Empathy basically is feeling and understanding when someone's going through something. So if you see a friend fall and get hurt and you see them crying, you kind of feel bad for that person. So you're showing that person empathy. Like, oh my God, I'm so sorry you fell. Are you okay? That must really hurt. So that's you showing empathy. Fear, so you look at the eyebrows, how they're raised. Surprise, they're also a little raised. And disgust. Disgust is basically when you don't like something, like, I don't know. Some people broccoli. Some people don't like broccoli. So if you don't like broccoli, you make like this weird, ugh, disgusting face. So basically, here's what it is with the mask. So when we're wearing our mask, we have to look at the eyes. So the eyes will show us the feeling. If you look at this picture without a mask, but you look at this one, you could compare. The eyes are pretty much the same. So that's something that's going to take practice when we go back to school. And that's something, a skill, a social emotional skill that we're going to practice. Try to figure out what we're feeling, what others are feeling so that we could help. So I'm going to ask, does anyone want to share something regarding these feelings charts? What do you notice between the two? Raise your hand, Ms. Blaze will call on you.
Alexandra? Go ahead, Alexandra.
I wanted to say that they both are the same because if you look at their hairs and you look at the other paper, if you see like the papers and you look at the hairs, they look the same thing from the pictures because they're the same people, but they're wearing masks because of the coronavirus.
Very good. Yes.
Thank you, Alexandra. That's beautiful.
Virus is in other places. So they put their masks, and then when they go to sun, they go to sun. Wait, to sun. Somebody, they need to wash their hands.
Exactly. Very good. So yes, you're absolutely right, friends. We have to wear a mask. You have to do your part to help keep everyone safe. So you have the power to help everyone in the school community in your neighborhood be safe. Thank you so much.
Like that. Now our program is almost finished for the first graders. We are actually going to share the screen and tell you what you're going to do when you go back to class. Okay, so this was shared with your teachers, but we want you to know after this, I'm going to show you a short video and then our program will be over. So, first graders, we want you to draw a picture of how you can help others either at home, at school, in your neighborhood. Plus, we want you to write one sentence about your drawing. So, you're going to draw a picture and then you're going to write one sentence about your drawing. Okay, now.
my kite.
Have you ever needed help to get something you couldn't reach? Probably needed help from someone bigger. Sometimes you might feel too small to help, but everyone has something that they can do to help others. You're never too small to help. Let's look at some of the different ways that you can help your family and your neighborhood. At home, you can help your family around the house. Maybe you can set the table or put the dishes in the dishwasher.
I can do that.
Maybe you can dust or water the plants.
I love watering the plants and watching them grow.
Or maybe you can play with a younger brother or sister while the adults cook dinner. If someone in your family is feeling sad, maybe you can help by drawing them a picture or giving them a hug.
This is for you.
But home isn't the only place where you can help others. You can help people wherever you go. Maybe when you're walking with your parents, you spot a neighbor who could use a hand with the groceries.
I can help you, Mrs. Garcia.
Or maybe when you are playing in the park, you and your family pick up trash. This helps keep the park nice and clean for everyone. Or maybe you and your family can help a family that needs a hand.
I like to help.
When you help others, it spreads a little happiness. When you make someone else's day brighter, you can make your day brighter too. No matter how big or small you are, there are always ways that you can help others. And there is nothing small about that.
Okay, scholars, so now the first graders, you guys actually, your program is done. We're actually going to end the video, okay? We want you to go back and do a drawing for us, and your teachers, this was shared with your teachers yesterday by Ms. Valencia. We're gonna get your drawings tomorrow. We hope you have fun. Mr. Walden, can you bring us back? Bye, first grade.